Hello everyone, my name is Deepak and welcome to this group presentation. This group consists of three members including me. Others are Declan and Nivedita. This presentation is divided into five sections. Introduction, design choice, scheduler key features, its pros and cons, performance evaluation, and conclusion. In this project, we are expected to develop a scheduler that can meet certain scheduling requirements based on given base scheduler. And these are lower wait time for high priority players, lower total wait time, lower longest response time, and lower number of contact switches. However, meeting all these criteria together is really a challenge. As I discussed, we have a few challenges here. There is a trade-off between different scheduler performance. For example, in round robin algorithm, if we try to reduce total wait time by reducing time quantum size, we can increase number of content switching. So we have a solution here. We have used multi-level queue structure. Here we have used four different queues. Each queue is a combination of round robin and SRTF, that is shortest remaining time first. When more than two players arrives at the same time, they are sorted based on SRTF. As you can see, players from higher priority queues are allowed to play first. Once this queue is empty, only then players from low priority queue can play next. When there is a timeout, players are preempted and they are pushed back into two different queues based on their priority, and they are scheduled in a similar fashion that I have already discussed here. So we have four different queues and it is their playing sequence. These are some of the key features of this scheduler. We have used quick sort algorithm to maintain SRTF queue because it is efficient and fast and it allows in-place sorting. However, it is fragile and it can generate worst case performance, but it is very rare. We have used shortest remaining time first queue because it can lower total wait time and it also allows preemptive scheduling. However, predicting next CPU burst is very difficult. Fortunately, in this simulation, it is already provided. Here, long jobs may starve. We have used round robin queue as well. It gives fair chance to each player to play, and it also lowers response time. However, if time quantum is not wisely chosen, it can increase total wait time and also content switching. Finally, we have used multi-level queue structure because it eliminates problem of starvation and it also allows flexible movement between different queues so that we can maintain our priority. This is a performance evaluation for test case. This is random test case one, which was given in the assignment. As you can see, our scheduler has passed all the tests successfully with a significant margin. As you can see, number of content switching are reduced to almost half, and that is a great achievement. And you can also see longest response time is reduced, total wait time is also reduced, and total wait time for higher priority player is reduced to almost half. Similarly, we have random test case two. It has also passed all the test criteria. And we have random test case three. This has also passed all the scheduling criteria, but with a little margin because now our queue is a bigger here. So it can distort some of the scheduling parameter. We have created a manual test case for worst case scenario. As you can see, many jobs are assigned with same arrival time. However, it has passed all the tests, but with a little margin. In conclusion, no single scheduler can satisfy all scheduling criteria. On one hand, SRTF gives minimum total wait time. On other hand, round robin can improve response time. So we have used combination of both. By using multi-level queue structure, we can allow different queues to schedule based on their priority. This is the end of my presentation. Thank you for your time.